everyone, welcome to our channel, we are the Paradoox. In this video, I'm gonna explain a bit about the presets and some tips about them, how to use them for different garments and so on. So, let's get started. Okay guys, as you can see, we have a sphere here and I want to test some of the presets on it. So, as you can see, there is no presets applied on it. And you know generally you can divide the presets into three categories. The first one would be the soft categories, that like silks, and the second categories would be the ones between the soft and stiffs, like cottons, and the third categories would be the one that is stiff, like the trims here. Okay, let's test some of them. As you know, cottons are they are not so stiff and not so soft, just between them. Simulating. So cottons are mostly like this. They will get some wrinkles, but not too much, and the wrinkles are a bit big, so the cottons would be good for pants, or you can use it for shirts too. So let's test another one, like silks. They are basically the soft presets. Okay, as you can see, the silk here compared to the cotton we simulated, it will get more wrinkles and a smaller wrinkles. So use it for garments that you need to have some smaller wrinkles, not like big wrinkles, you know, like a female dress, like a cape. So let's test another one from the hard presets, stiff presets. Okay, we will choose the trim full grain leather. It's one of the most stiff presets here in Marvelous. You see, this preset has basically no wrinkles. It's so stiff, and the trims are mostly like this, but this one is the top of them. You can use this preset for like the parts that need to be so hard, like for armors, like parts you don't need to get some, you don't need to get any wrinkles, so you need to use trims. Most of the time when I'm creating garments here, I will layer it on defaults, and at the end I will choose the presets I want. The most presets I use would be the trim hardware, the wool, and the cotton canvas. Sometimes I use nylon featherweight, or like leather, or denim lightweight. I use that for pants, and for face mask, cotton heavy canvas for hats, trim hardware for some part of the garment that you don't need them to get any wrinkles, like a belt, and the wool. I use the wool for jackets, and silks for female dress, and some of the other fabrics based on what I want at that moment. You know, just play with them and test them to see how are their wrinkles. Some of them, as you see, they will have some big wrinkles. Like, you can use a trim hardware for like a t-shirt, you know, because your t-shirt needs to have some small wrinkles, and the trim hardware will make it to stand so stiff. So you can't use a trim hardware or a trim full grain leather for like a t-shirt or a shirt, but instead you can use them for something like an armor. And like for silks, you can use silks, like I mentioned it, for female dress, but at the same time you can use silks for something like a hat or the brim of it. So just test them a bit, and because there are so many here, so many fabrics, if I want to test all of them, the video will be too long. So that would be for the presets. Okay, and there is something else about the fabrics. Every preset you see here has their own settings. Like if we choose trim hardware, and from here under the preset details, if we select on the details, you will see some settings, and every one of them will do something like shear or stretch weft or warp or density, frictions, and you can just change them based on what you need. And here, like for example, this one is trim hardware. We will reduce the shear and simulating. You will see here the fabrics, it's like become so heavy. And again, if we increase the shear and simulating, the fabric is like become so light and go up. So you can just adjust these settings based on what you need. Most of the times I just adjust the density and the shear or the frictions, and sometimes it would be the stretch weft and warp. It would be depends on what kind of garment are you working. Like for example, if you work with if you want to create a hat for the brim, sometimes you use the trim hardware, but the brim won't just stand there, and you need to just adjust some of the settings for the brim so it will just stand stiff. Okay, there is something else about the fabrics here. You see, when you select on a fabric here on the type, there is some kind of type here, like shiny, velvet, glass or leather, metal, plastic. There are some kinds of type here, and you can choose them, but remember they will have no effect on the presets. Like you can let me change the color. Okay, be red, and here you can put it on shiny. You will see the difference here. We can put it on plastic, it will be like this, or you can put it on metal, it will be like this. But remember, like I mentioned it, there is you know, the type won't have any effect on the presets. Like you can choose silks here, and you know silks are so soft, but you can put the type on metal, you see. Or you can choose something like trim hardware and put the type on something like plastic or like velvet. So you can put the type on based on what you need at the moment. So that was for type. Okay, there is something else about the presets. From here, I mentioned that every preset has their own settings, like silks. If you select on the details, there is a settings here, and if you select on the trim hardware, there is another setting. So from this option here, you can import the presets. If you download any presets, you can import it from here. And you, if you want to create your own presets, you can just click on any presets here you want, like denim lightweight here. You can adjust the settings, increase them or decrease them, and at the end, you, from this option here, you can export it and save it as your own presets. Okay, another thing would be about the thickness. In details, you can give thickness to your fabrics, but I don't give thickness to my garments like this. I will just select on them, and from here at thickness renderings, I will give them the thickness that I want, because from here fabrics and details, if you give thickness, the thickness will apply to this fabric, and if you, and this fabrics will maybe contains pants or shirts too, and this thickness will apply to both of them, the pants and the shirts. But sometimes you don't want the pants to be the same thickness as the shirts, so you will just click on them and give them thickness from here. I will do that all the time. There is something else in the details section here, and I use that more than the others, and that is frictions. Imagine that you have a t-shirt, and here like a corset and pants, and there is a overcoat over them, and your character has an animation like a dance or walk, no matter, but you want the overcoat to just stay there, you know, you don't want it to be dragged away, just pulled away, and you want it to just stay there that already is. So the thing is, you need to see what fabric the overcoat is. You see overcoat is here, and you need to put the friction, you just need to increase the friction. In that case, the friction of the overcoat will be increased, and like it won't drag the way when the character is walking or running or dancing, doesn't matter, it will just stay there. Thank you very much guys for watching this video. I hope I was able to help you. As always, if you had any questions, just let me know in the comment section. And if you did not subscribe to our channel, please subscribe to it. Thank you very much. I will see you in the next tutorial.